Hello you guys, so today I am walking you through my spring doggy routine. And the only difference really between spring and winter are some of the products I use and cleaning the house a bit more. So of course before you begin bathing your dogs, you want to clean up the house a bit by vacuuming and doing the laundry so that you get rid of dust mites and any flea eggs and anything else really that's gonna irritate your doggy. So during the spring I like to give an oat bath, so pretty much I get some plain oats and blend them up, and I'll have two different types. One I'll create a paste and the other I'll use to sprinkle in the tub depending on how dry and itchy their skin is, but the entire process is really simple. So now that the oats are all ground up, I'll put that in a one container, and these oats are for putting in the bath. So if you're drawing a bath for your dog, you'll just let them soak in the oats that are in the water. Now the oats I'm putting in the separate container, I'm creating a paste, and that paste I'll put on my dogs while they're in the tub and let them soak on my dog for a few minutes. That helps with itchy fur, and Maxie is the itchiest dog I have, and Roxy tends to not have any issues, not any seasonal or allergy issues, so I just throw oats on her so that she doesn't get jealous. I usually bathe them separately, but for the sake of this video, I bathe them together, and sometimes if I'm in a rush or there's a lot going on that day, I'll bathe them together. This is a new shampoo I've been using. I really love the smell of it. It's very calm and you can barely smell it, but it's really nice when you're cuddling your doggy. You want to be gentle when you're massaging the shampoo into your doggy, and you want to make sure that you don't get any of the shampoo in their eyes or their ears or anywhere near their mouth. By this time the paste is really thick, so it's really easy to apply, and I'm just massaging it into Max's back because that's where his skin is the driest, and also he's been biting a lot, so his lips are a bit crusty and I'm just putting the oatmeal around his lips and he's trying to eat it, and Roxy's getting jealous, so I'm gonna add a bit to her as well.
She like a little newborn baby? So does she like a newborn baby? I'm gonna let her run. Doggy. You want a treat? You want a treat? Come on. Let's go get a treat. Come on. Come on, Rocky. Come on.
it's always important to give your doggies treats after they've taken a bath because they act like it's the most traumatic experience ever. Okay, so now they're all dried for the most part, and I like to add this Burt's Bees itchy relieving spray. It's really good for itchy skin, not so good for hot spots. So if your dog has hot spots, then you might need to go to your vet for a spray for that. And I use Advantage Multi as their flea preventative and their tick and heartworm preventative. And yeah, that product pretty much covers everything that we worry about all year round, but especially in the spring. You should apply preventative all year, even though you don't really see fleas or anything until spring. But yeah, so I apply those two to them and just let them chill out. Thanks so much for watching, you guys. Turn on notifications and please subscribe. And I'll see you in my next video. Bye.